G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. I'm thinking about doing a little video series on building the Tamiya 222, basically just for beginners. If you're just starting out modelling, I was thinking about just doing a little series on this. And I'm probably going to do one or two of these at the same time. So I was going to do one pretty much out of the box, and then I was going to actually put some accessories on the other one that I'm probably going to do. So with that in mind, I thought I'd do a couple of reviews of some of the stuff that I'm thinking about possibly putting on the second one. And then once I sort of get through picking up some of that stuff, I'll start doing a build series on the 222. So with that in mind, I picked up this little set from Mantis Miniatures. I just wanted to have a look at this. Most of the quality of the stuff I've got from Mantis Miniatures has actually been really nice casting. So I'll be surprised if this is any different. A couple of things on here I probably would use, some things I might not use, I'm not too sure 100%. I'll zoom in, I might put one or two pictures up from their website pictures just to show you a bit of close-ups, but I thought we'd have a look at the casting. So not too much in this set, only five pieces really that you get. We might just start with the spare wheel. So here it is here, and I've got the Tamiya one here. So as you can see, this one just probably has a bit more loose material on, if you like, on the cover. It sort of has a lot more creases in it and around the edges as well, where the Tamiya one is reasonably quite tight, and you do get this seam line around the edge there with the Tamiya one that you've got to clean up. And I just thought it was interesting to have a look at this, and you sort of get the stitching around the front of this one where you're sort of not really getting it on the Tamiya one. Sometimes with the four-wheel drives, you can get one that stretches right over the top and there isn't a seam line on it, and it sort of comes down the back there. And other ones, you do get this sort of stitching line around the front there. You know, obviously there might be different ones as well, but just probably for a static model, I think this one does look a little bit more pleasing, especially when you start, you know, doing your highs and lows on the creases and stuff like that. I think that will look more pleasing. Whether it's correct or not, I'm not 100% sure. But I thought it would just add a bit more interest to the model. If you're just building it out of a box, I actually think this is perfectly fine. I mean, by the time you put it on, and you can obviously weather it a little bit and stuff like that, I think it's perfectly fine, especially when you can pick this kit up now for a reasonably cheap price. If you're building it out of the box, I don't think you'll, you know, really have a major problem with this one. But if you're just wanting to sort of detail your kit up a little bit more and add a bit more interest, I thought this one, you know, was reasonably good. There are a couple of different sets out there for the 222. I think Legend's done a set as well, which you might have a look at and compare these. I did really like this piece here. You've got your sort of your jerry can with your sort of brackets on it underneath there. And then you've actually got some really nice rope wrapped around it, which is cast exceptionally well. And then you've obviously got a helmet, a little bag there, some water bottles, and I was just really amazed. I mean, if you can see that rope there, how well it was cast. And even underneath here, you can see there's a gap in there where the canteen goes in. Really cleanly done. And some of the black dog ones I've got of jerry cans haven't turned out exceptionally well. You can even see the little bracket there on the edges there. Just a really nice piece. I was really impressed when I pulled this piece out. The same with this piece here. I was amazed at how well they've done this chain around all the contents here. It's just also cast really well. Some of these chains you can get and they have broken links in them quite badly and almost makes it pointless using it, but this one's done reasonably well, I think very well actually. And the contents here, I'm not accidentally sure what this thing is here. One of you guys might know. I'm not sure what this piece of equipment is here, whether it's just a wooden box and you've got some sort of, you know, little tin can there or something like that. And then I think this is one of your sort of food storage containers, I think. But even this mesh over the top, this sort of camo net, I mean, look how neatly that's done. And it's sort of believable. Cast again exceptionally well. And this sort of sits on the front of the bumper bar, if you like, or the ball bar at the front, whatever you want to call that thing. Yeah, I do have a question. A mid question for you guys, if anyone out there is watching. I would be curious to know what these things are at the front. I don't think it actually says on the Tamiya box what these things actually are. So I would be curious to know what these things are. And that's where this thing's supposed to replace and sit on the front here and replace these things here. So if someone knows, leave it in the comments. Just the final two pieces here. And again, I mean, if you look at the casting on these, really nice. Sometimes when you get these jerry cans, they come out pretty woeful in some other sets. If you've seen one of my Black Dogs reviews on some. But I mean, you can see here, I mean, for casting and resin, it's, I think it's done really well. Sometimes I opt for, if I've picked up a bad casting of these, I might opt to pick up the, take some plastic handles off a plastic kit and whack them on and not put these sort of handles on these jerry cans. If the resin ones are really bad, this one's done perfectly fine for me. And even on the other side there, you can sort of see how they've got this sort of coat sort of wrapping through and coming in and out, tucked around. And that obviously is going to be against the vehicle like that, so you're not really going to see that side. And I'll just show you the back of this one. Again, you can see the nice straps and the creases. And over this side, I mean, you've got some nice buckles there and some sort of food container, or who knows what you might do in that. But there's some sort of little container there. And you've got this little mess tin there. And I don't know, I always remember these, this little sort of thing underneath being, I think like for grenades or something from the Tamiya's old sets or something like that. I'm not sure exactly what that this one is here. That's what I used to think it is, or thought it was. It was one of the grenade sort of boxes for grenades and stuff like that. But anyway, someone else can let me know in the comments. But again, all these pieces I've been really happy with. I think they've done a great job. I mean, even look at the little wire bit there. I mean, there's a little bit of flash on a couple of these pieces, but you know, nothing to really, very thin. Yeah, nothing that a hobby knife isn't going to take off in about 30 seconds. Very, very clean. So you're not going to need to get a razor saw out or anything like that to clean up this. So there you go, guys. If you're interested in building a 222, I think I'll do a little video series on building one up. It's a reasonably easy kit to build up. I built one up quite some time ago. Whether you get the photo etch model with the photo etch in it, or whether you just get the one with the mesh in it. Other than that, they're pretty very similar. It's a reasonably cheap kit to pick up these days. It goes together pretty well and pretty quickly. There you go, guys. Hope you enjoyed having a look at this one. As far as casting goes, I think the casting's absolutely fantastic. Whether I'll use all the parts on the one, I'm not too sure, because I might pick up a couple other little detailed sets and I might, you know, mix and match things. But other than that, this set, really happy with it. All the pieces look really nice. No really major bad air bubbles or terrible casting lines in terrible places. Just a really nice set. Hope you like this one. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.